This one's about America. It's called The Stars and the Stripes. Hoodwinked by the stars in the eyes of the American dreams, sleepwalking through the red stripe and the lucky strike and the killing fields of green, stained with the invisible blood of mother's sons now laid to rest, faceless soldiers who fought their damnedest, planted like seeds at regular intervals, with line after line and row upon row of hundreds and thousands of manicured headstones for silent dead heroes, laid out like white marble stripes on the red and blue flag of capitalist consumerism, who died in their country's pursuit of world supremacism, where oil and beef and the arms industries are king, and the multiplicity of the dollar sign is everything, cha-ching. Seen through the myopic blinkered lens of tunnel vision, which honors the rights of the man-made corporation over and above those of the individual or the community, completely disregarding compassion, union, and ecological sustainability in preference of a quarterly profit margin. Somehow we became removed from the natural world with an absence of humility, a breed apart, the needy, greedy, self-important human, with no choice now but to career full steam ahead towards chaos and rumination. Though maybe, just maybe, we can still save the day through a reclamation of self-love, equality, and a natural heart connection. Together now, let us pray for sweet love's healing salvation. This one's a feminist slant. It's for women everywhere. It's called Liberty Moon. There's still a lot of pressure from society upon women, the kind that prevents her from becoming anything more than a second-class citizen, more than the procurer of the genetic lineage and procreative service, more than a glamorous profile picture, wallpaper, calendar, screensaver, accessory, more than a cook, carer, au pair, affair, or nanny. Often the weight of relationship responsibility prevents one from fulfilling one's true vocational destiny, from uncovering that hidden latent potential deep within every individual, denies the opportunity to discover and follow what that actually might be, and so it can become a bit of a struggle to balance relationship, kids, career, leisure, pleasure, ambition, and maybe also survival, perhaps also a battle to fight for one's right to an education if one's family is not well off, supported, or stable. Maybe one lives in or is from a Muslim or third world country where one may suddenly find oneself given away as a child or teenage bride by one's own family. And so modern day opportunities are put aside. Instead, centuries of tradition, dogma, stigma, or religious doctrine is thrust upon, prevented from falling in love and following one's heart, for example, limited by having one's life path or life partner pre-chosen, designed to promote subservience, to know one's place and fit in, rather than being able to feel secure within one's own skin through empowerment, bliss, and freedom, disallowed from making one's own wrong choices too, on the experiential path of self-knowledge, growth, and understanding, from maturing, growing out of old illusions in one's own time gracefully. But even now, in this day and age, there still persists a supermassive infringement of personal liberty, even from other women.